Oh, that's so sad. Caroline Marcille botches the Star-Spangled Banner before a hockey game in Canada, but a little booing isn't going to stop her. She's determined to get it right, so she goes and grabs the words on a note card and heads back down to try again. And then, okay, now here she comes and... Oh!
Oh, ouch!
Oh, no, she slips on the ice and goes down. Look at her, she's in tears, Lauren. She picks herself up, but enough is enough. This time she walks out for good.
Oilers slowly coming back. They have the move. Oh my goodness!
As the puck bounds off of the goaltender, Murray out in front of the net. Foreman beats the defender to the puck. As you can see, Murray tried to trap that. It bounds right to the net. Jordan Foreman beats Jakob Kindle to the puck, and he puts it in for a 5-4 lead for the London Knights.
Výpad Mortena Greena totiž zakončil do vlastní brány japonský obránce Sugawara. Hokejové harakiri nešťastníka Sugawary poslalo Japonce do boju o záchranu. Prohráli totiž s Dánskem 3-4.
Was ready, wants a check, moves it off for Justin Williams. Williams for Big Joe, the Condor, on the move, holding, tries to split the D, Watson, and a penalty upcoming against Washington. Good move by Watson. Wallin plays it outside the line, and he scores on his own goal. Incredibly, Nick Wallin sends it back. Ward had left on a delayed whistle, and that counts for Washington. Oh, Nick Wallin looks for a place to hide.
Oh, wow. John, you and I have been working together for 6 years. I don't think we've ever seen this, and you have to feel badly for Wallin right now. A delayed penalty. Ward had obviously gone to the bench for the extra attacker, and let's see if it's the stick work of Washington playing through to the whistle. And I'm not sure exactly what Nick was trying to do with it. Just slid off his stick. I don't know who he was trying to find with that pass, and fortunately it had dead aim.
Oh my goodness.
So they just simply weren't happy, and they had to find a taker for Abisher, so they found one. Certainly a big salary depth.
Oh, and it's in! Oh no! Sebastian Perron, a nightmare bounce. Ivan Majewski just scored his first goal of the season.
Words cannot describe this goal.
The old 170-foot shot.
Lucky bounce, yes. 170.
Play by Taylor Chorney. You saw the strength of a Poso to protect that puck just inside his line on his backhand. You also saw a little... Score! Oh my! Robbie Vina! Are you kidding me? You know what? This might be the biggest challenge for Minnesota tonight, if they can shake this off. The bounce, and Frazee beat himself because he was too deep.
That's really... ...in the puck in the zone as well.
Got hit by Ruutu.
Now he comes back. Sorry, but... We know what happened there.
One, Dennis Wideman, and looks like Barry Melrose after his first beer. I mean, he's going to get the CCM double runners for the next St. Louis Blue game.
Ew.
And Wideman, he just toe-picked it, crazy-legged it to the corner.
36 seconds remaining. Ryan Smith trying to move it deep. Locates Bergeron, and Stu Barnes stripped him. Steffen's attempt at the empty net hit a body. That's why there's no icing. Maybe one last gasp here for the Oilers. Bergeron fans on a pass. Steffen steals, and he'll ice it. Oh, at least I thought he was going to until he blew it. That's unbelievable. Here come the Oilers the other way, and Hemsky's loose. Hemsky, he scored. Can you believe what?
the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen. Patrick Steffen, you should be embarrassed for what you just did. That does not belong in the National Hockey League. And then the puck is turned over. Stoll gets the puck up, and shockingly, it's Ryan Smith. Alex Hemsky makes a remarkable move, and the Oilers somehow are going to send this game to overtime as Alex Hemsky's seventh goal of the season ties the game with 2 seconds left. That's the most embarrassing thing I've seen on the National Hockey League ice. And I don't know, I've been around the game 25 years at the pro level. That is unbelievable.